Listen to the footsteps behind you. Listen to the voices in the dark. Listen to the screams in the night. Listen to the haunted cabaret. With your host, George Garner.
Lurking just beyond Lovecraft's Providence on Rhode Island Free Radio. Inaugurating the rebirth of the Haunted Cabaret. I'm George Garner, and with me, as previously and as now, the many times reincarnated and still terrifying, Chuckles the Clown. Chuckles, welcome back to the Haunted Cabaret.
It is nice to be back in a radio studio that is not going to charge me to use the facilities.
We will not charge you to do anything.
Excellent. That sounds like a good time to me.
Right now, we are located in a circa 1930s building that looks something like, I don't know, what would you say, something from Humphrey Bogart meets Dracula type of thing. So,
this is definitely the detective feeling to it. I don't know about Humphrey Bogart. I'm looking a little bit more towards my buddy there from, you know, the Birds and Psycho and all that stuff. I'm looking more towards Alfred
Hitchcock. There we go.
You know, Alfred had a lot of great mystery movies besides his horror flicks, but we'll talk about that another day.
And as far as Hitchcock, I mean, I'm looking at this door. Now, we have one of these old-fashioned doors with a window in it, and I can almost imagine the fat man walking in front of that window in profile.
I can see it, except for I just saw a fat woman walk by the window, so maybe that's what you were seeing.
Maybe. Besides the birth of the rebirth of the Haunted Cabaret, obviously the topic to discuss is the rebirth of Godzilla.
I loved it.
I thought it was good. We'll do a little, I don't know, Siskel and Ebert. Does anybody remember those people?
No, and thank God.
Speaking of the fat man and the skinny man.
Let me correct myself. Thank the devil that no one remembers them. I apologize for that, the listeners out there. A little out of character for myself.
Yeah. Speaking of the devil, when we get back from the music, we'll talk all about the new Godzilla flick. Right now, let's listen to a little bit of Abigail here on the Haunted Cabaret on Rhode Island Free Radio.
Speaking to her.
All right, that was King Diamond with Abigail from basically, I think, my favorite concept album in the history of music. I mean, I don't think much of The Who and stuff like that. I mean, those are poor excuses for concept albums compared to King Diamond singing Abigail in that helium, adulterated, deranged voice of his.
I'm just going to say right. Didn't agree with you with that one.
You'd better.
Yeah, I will.
You'd better, because you're not that far from me in this room. This is a very small studio, about 250 square feet, full of atmosphere, but should we really antagonize each other, we are within striking distance.
And I left my weapons in the car again. Well, in the ambulance. They wouldn't let me take them out.
Speaking of weapons, now, we had mentioned that we were going to talk about the new Godzilla film, you know, when we came back, and here we are back. Now, the consensus in this room seems to be that you, Chuckles, are incredibly impressed by this. Yep. I am a bit less so, but still enjoyed it.
You got to see where I'm coming from. That 1998 piece of trash that came out was the most horrible thing known for Godzilla. So, yes, this thing coming out.
Well, I agree with that 1,001%, yes.
This thing come out to give birth back to Godzilla and bring the young kids back into this was incredible.
So what you're telling me is that after screwing maybe the most ugly chick in the universe, you know, the one that's halfway decent looks a lot better than it would otherwise.
Exactly.
Okay, I'll go along with that.
Now, I will give you this. The actress in that was horrible.
She should have been a stepped-on casualty.
Yeah, they could have replaced her with Megan Fox, and it would have been better. She had no acting talent whatsoever. It was one of the Olsen twin sisters. I can't remember her name.
I'm not sure, but she was just one of those cookie-cutter blondes that really serves no purpose in a movie.
Which is why you didn't see her in half the movie. She's underground, hidden by gravel, where she belonged.
Right, and I'll tell you now, all right, speaking of things we didn't see in the movie, okay, here's my basic big complaint. What we did not see in a Godzilla movie, okay, now Godzilla attacks San Francisco, we did not see an all-out battle between Godzilla and the American military. Think about it. That was not in every single Godzilla film, there is supposed to be that moment when Godzilla walks out of the bay, wherever, whatever city he might be attacking. The ships are lined up, the tanks are lined up, the gunners are lined up. Everyone unloads on Godzilla, and he proceeds to blast the living hell out of, you know, the nation's military, whichever nation that might be. We did not get that moment. They set it up like they were going to, right? They lined up the aircraft carriers, the destroyers,
yep,
the tanks on the Golden Gate Bridge.
On the bridge.
I was waiting for that moment when he rises out of the water.
Well, it was kind of like a World War II reincarnation. You know, the Germans marched right in and took over France. Godzilla marched right in and took over San Francisco. The military was set up.
Godzilla, yes.
But you never got the battle. But they did appease you by showing you part of that. But I see where the director was coming from, which is not your typical Godzilla movie where they made Godzilla a hero. Growing up, you know that Godzilla is not a hero, a villain, nevertheless, and a monster. And the only reason he's going towards this area is to rumble with that other creature. Doesn't care what other victims or civilians are in his way. He's going to squish him and fight this thing.
Basically a force of nature.
Right. It's like putting a lion in the freaking cage with a wildebeest. It's going to be a fight. That's the only reason those two contact each other. But they made it into a good guy character, which there were certain Godzilla flicks where Godzilla was the hero, where
well,
they tried...
Yeah, back